Hi, this is Alfauzia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we're going to discuss in our today's video is basic rules of probability. Now, we move on to learning some of the basic rules of probability. Fortunately, these rules are very intuitive, and as long as they apply systematically, they will let us solve more complicated problems, in particular, those problems for which our intuition might be inadequate. Since most of the probabilities you will be asked to find can be calculated using both logic and counting, and the rules we will be learning. So first let me give you the principle. If you can calculate a probability using logic and counting, you need not use a probability rule. So let us start learning the basic rule, basic five rules of probability now. Our first rule simply reminds us of the basic property of probability that we have already learned. The probability of an event which informs us of the likelihood of its occurring can range anywhere from 0 to, and this is indicating that the event will never occur. 0 means the event will never occur, to 1. This indicates that the event is certain. Certain means for sure. So probability rule 1. The probability P of A of any event A satisfies that the probability will lie in between 0 and 1. One practical use of this rule is that it can be used to identify any probability calculation that comes out to be more than 1 or less than 0 as incorrect. For example, if you are getting the answer as a negative number, negative 0.34, or a number larger than 1.5 something, it means your answer is incorrect. So you should get answers for all the probability problems in between the numbers 0 and 1. Before moving on to the other rules, let's first look at an example that will provide a context for illustrating the next several rules. Here is an example. Okay. I have given a table. A person in the United States is chosen at random. What is the probability of the person having a blood type A? Our intuition tells us that since the four blood types O, A, B and AB exhaust all the possibilities, their probabilities together must sum to 1. If you add all these probabilities, it should be equal to 1. So which is the probability of a certain event? A person has one of these four blood types for certain. Since the probabilities for O, B and AB together, if you add all this 0.44 plus 0.10 plus 0.04, you will get 0.58, right? The probability of type A must be the remaining. So if you just subtract the answer from 1, you will get the answer for probability of A. So please subtract 0.58 from 1. Yes, I'm getting 0.42. Hope you're clear with this example. So it lies in between 0 and 1 only. Probability rule number 2. If S is a sample space in the probability model, then probability of S is equal to 1. So this tells us that the probability of all possible outcomes together must be equal to 1. The sum of the probabilities of all possible outcomes is equal to 1. So this is a good place to compare and contrast what we are doing here with what we learned. The table which I have shown, the blood group table. If you add all the probabilities, it should be equal to 1. That is the rule. That is the second rule. So I have just used this concept there by subtracting 0.58. Hope you are clear with this concept. Now let's move on to the rule number 3. This is called probability involving multiple events. We will often be interested in finding probabilities involving multiple events, such as probability of A or B or probability of A and B. This is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. You can read this as probability of event A occurs or event B occurs or both occurs. That is the meaning of this one. Even this can be read as probability of both event A occurs and event B occurs. Okay. The probability or means either one or the other or both. So probability of A or B is nothing but probability of event A occurs or event B occurs or both occurs. Now the fourth rule, for any event A, probability of the complement. The complement of the event A is equal to 1 minus probability of the event. In probability and its applications, we are frequently interested in finding out the probability that a certain event will not occur. An important point to understand here is that event A does not occur is a separate event that consists of all the possible outcomes that are not in A. That is called the complement event of A. Please notice that we will write not A or complement C to denote the event of A that does not occur. This rule deals with the relationship between the probability of an event and the probability of its complement event. Given that event A and event the complement A together makes up all possible outcomes, and you know this rule, sum of all the possible outcome is equal to 1. This tells us that the sum of the probabilities of all possible outcomes is 1. So, this rule should be quite intuitive, this complement rule. Probability of A complement is equal to 1 minus probability of that event. That is, the probability that an event does not occur is 1 minus the probability that it does occur. Am I right? So, I would like to give you an example. Back to the blood type example. I'll give you some additional information. A person with type A can donate blood to a person with type A or AB. A person with type B can donate blood to a person with type B or AB. So these are the general information. Okay. What is the probability that a randomly chosen person cannot donate blood to everyone? In other words, what is the probability that a randomly chosen person does not have blood type O? We need to find probability of O complement here. Am I right? Here I am going to use the complement formula. Probability of complement of an event is equal to 1 minus probability of that event. Here donating blood group O. Okay. Probability that a randomly chosen person does not have the blood type O. So here, what is the probability of O? This is 0.44. Am I right? Just plug in the value from the table. You may also get word problems with some difficult clue. This one is a very direct, straightforward one. The information are given directly. The probability values for each of the blood type is given in the table. So you can directly take the probability value from the table and then plug in here and then solve this one. So 1 minus 0.44. So the probability of the not O or complement O is 0.56. You may also give your answer in percentage. So if you are giving the answer in percentage, it means that 56% of the population does not have the blood type O. Am I right? This property is very very important property. Please note that the complement rule, probability of A complement is equal to 1 minus probability of the event A, can be reformulated as, you can just change the places as we generally do in algebra. So probability of an event is nothing but 1 minus probability of not that event. This can be reformulated in this way. This seemingly trivial algebraic manipulation has an important application, and it actually captures the strength of the complement rule. In some cases, when finding probability of A directly would be very difficult, very complicated. It might be much easier to find probability of not an event and then just subtract it from 1 to get the desired probability of the event A. Okay. You can use the complement rule whenever it is easier to calculate the probability of the complement of the event rather than the event itself. Also, please notice that we use the phrase at least 1 for this rule. Okay. I'll give you the formula. Probability of none is equal to, it can be any event. Probability of none of the event is equal to 1 minus probability of at least 1 of the event. This is a common application of the complement rule, which you can often recognize the phrase at least 1 in the problem. And the last rule is involving the multiple events. What is mean by disjoint? For example, if you are considering a Venn diagram, okay, I'll give you. A Venn diagram suggests that another way to think about the disjoint versus disjoint event is that disjoint events that do not overlap. They do not share any of the possible outcomes and therefore cannot happen together. So this is how the disjoint event Venn diagram will look like. Okay, these are the five important basic rules of probability. In case if you get any query regarding this topic, please let me know. See you in the next video. Have a great time ahead.